Hello guys, this is the sixth week of Weekly Info, and I have a special guest, and he's Henry Tompkins.
Hello.
This week, we are going to be learning about what is a tornado, and he's going to be with us for 5 weeks, and maybe more. Okay.
Maybe.
So, a tornado is a spinning vortex with hot and cool air mixing together, and tornadoes can form in two different ways, one from spinning sideways and one spinning up. There is five scales of a tornado, which is
six.
What we're going to be learning about in the next video. I did it for my edit. I'm going to edit and make like a big five on six on the screen just to make it.
We'll be learning about that in the next week.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
We don't want to do it all in 1 week because that'll be boring for y'all. Okay.
Yes.
So,
no one likes boring.
There is two ways, and I think Henry wants to explain that because he has not have a turn yet.
2,000 years later.
One way that tornadoes form is when there's two ways that tornadoes form. One, sideways and so.
And how do they form?
It is when positive and negative air, positive warm air or negative cool air combined in a storm, and it causes tornadoes.
And that exactly. And thank you for watching this week. It was short, but trust me, the next weeks are going to be very long. And next week, we're going to be learning about the enhanced fajita scale. Hello, guys. And I'm back with What is a Tornado? And so this week, we're going to be learning about the EF scale. EF means enhanced fajita. Okay?
No, it's fajita.
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 Dad, go get the fajita from the oven.
It's fajita. It's fajita.
Okay, we're good. We're good.
It's
we're good.
It's fajita. It's fajita. Don't listen to him. He's lying.
It's fajita.
It's fajita.
It's fajita.
Fajita.
1,000 years later.
We're just going to be calling it fajita. Okay? I mean, fajita.
Fajita.
Okay, we're back with the argument and no harm done. And don't listen to them. And we're going to be learning about, and it's called fajita.
Okay.
And yeah, EF zero. What can you explain to EF zero?
It is minor or no damage. Knocks down a few trees and moves mailboxes.
And an EF one is minor damage, and it can uproot
one
tree. Can strip roof it. And it is minor damage.
Three is severe damage.
And is EF three is severe damage. It can lift cars up and throw them. It can also break windows and basically destroy a lot. And you can see a lot of damage. Houses are still in their place.
EF four makes total destruction of mobile homes. Roofs are entirely ripped off and thrown. Most trees and forests are outrooted and thrown.
EF5 is severe. It's major damage. Extreme damage. Houses are moved from their foundations. Cars, probably won't get to see your fancy car again. Yes, and we'll see you in the next week. Hello guys, we're in week 8. Where are you getting 3 from? Okay, it's week 8. And we're going to be learning about prevention and safety. And here's a good way how to be safe. You never go outside if there's a tornado, okay? Even if there's an EF zero, you never go outside. You usually want to get to the middle of your house or a room with no windows. Or your bathroom.
Middle bathroom is the same.
Never go on a top story of your house, nor side buildings with windows. If you do not have a room with no windows, but you have a basement, go in the basement. If you don't have a basement,
if you don't,
you go in your tub and put a mattress above your head.
Also,
okay?
Just so you know, if you have a basement, go there no matter what. That's the first thing you want to do is go to the basement. Underground is the only true safe place from EF5s and any tornado, baby.
And prevention has to be, you usually want to have a generator for your house. And because you could be trapped under your house for many days, you usually want to have a flashlight.
Food and water, definitely.
And cans. You do not want non-cans. Do not use gas or any other. Do not burn anything to get the rescue things. It might sound like a good idea, but no. And yeah, that's how you prevent it. And then we also need to be careful of, if you do not have shoes, just don't get out of the house. If you can get out of the house and you have shoes on, you want to go, okay? But if it's raining, you know. Hello guys, and Henry's gonna be doing this week. And it is called
the Tri-State Tornado, also known as the deadliest tornado. Get out of the front cabin.
You may continue.
And what happened was more than more than 695 people died. It was an EF5, and it lasted for 3 hours and 29 minutes and 52 seconds. And what happened was that it started in one state and ended up, it went through three states that
it is
about the name Tri-State Tornado. Back to you, Tappan.
Yes, and back to me. And thank you for watching this week. Next week is the next week. And we're gonna, you're gonna learn how to make your own tornado at home, and it's gonna be fun. We also have our sponsors of the video is coming up in the next video, and yes, and thank you for watching this video, and you will love the next video, and this is the second to last video of the tornado.
This is a contraption he made with his dad.
Yes.
Tevin, would you like to explain how you made it?
I would like to. So how we made this was we put dish soap, it can be any soap, and then we put like vinegar because it loosens the soap, and we did food coloring to make it gray, and we would definitely like to show you it. So let's bring the camera over here. Thank you, invisible cameraman.
Just so you know, it went out green.
It is gray. It's viewers, do not comment on me.
That is the end result of
what
happens.
Okay, and then let me explain this.
End result.
Okay, it's forming right now. Oh, sorry. It is forming right now, and now it's touched down and it's becoming more strong, and then now it's loosening. And that's how you can learn about tornado. And then we can all, this is a fun way how to make a supercell. Go, shake it up and down, and then you turn it. It's spinning, as you can see, that really big tornado. Okay? And this is the last video, and we're gonna go through our sponsors of the day. We have many sponsors. Hello guys, and it's back with weekly info. We also have a guest coming in our next week, which I would not be saying who. And we would like to present our sponsors of the video. Our sponsors of the video are, we got National Geographic, we got www.weather.gov. We also got NASA, because we have a new book coming out. And then
wrote it.
I wrote, and it's all about tornadoes and different types of tornadoes. You will learn about a tornado you do not know about, and he doesn't even know about it. You want to guess?
Honestly, I don't think I can, because I don't know about it.
Yeah, so you want to read that book. Okay, we also have another sponsor, which is Pokemon, and let me go get my Pokemon card.
Philippines! Wait,
Flip what? Got him! Oh. Okay, now let me explain.
I don't care!
How you can get these bad boys. You go to www. Let me rephrase that. Okay, so how you can get them is you're going to go to primeclothes.godaddysites.com. But clothes is spelled C-L-O-S-E.godaddy.org. I mean, not .org.
Okay?
It's right here on the screen. When you go in, it should say you have any questions. If you want to enter, you'll get them, you'll get a code, and we will be revealing the code in week 11, because this is week 10. If you want these bad boys, well, you better get them.